On completing this chapter, you will have an understanding of the standard procedures when a crude oil tanker arrives at port, the formalities when port authorities and terminal representatives embark, the process for cargo tank survey and sampling by independent cargo surveyors, the process concerning connecting cargo hoses arms, the terminal requirements, the agreed discharge plan. How can pre-berthing information exchanged between the master, the agent, and the terminal help the ship's crew to prepare and be well ahead of scheduled operations? When the vessel arrives at port, she proceeds through the standard activities. Pilot on board, entering into port, and moving alongside the terminal or SPM buoy, assisted by tugboats. If discharged by ship-to-ship operation, see CBT number 0181. As soon as information on which side alongside is received, the bosun and crew make ready the moorings and, together with the pumpman, prepare the cargo manifolds. Note: because of improved communication systems, SATCOM, email, etc., exchange of pre-berthing information between the vessel, agent, and terminal enables the vessel to make good use of the time and be well ahead of schedule when berthed. Examples: preparing manifolds on the correct side, fitting reducers of the correct size to the manifolds, preparing the gangway, security register, and visitors' briefing cards on the correct side, updating the discharge plan to allow for last-minute requests from the terminal, such as a slower receiving rate or a line displacement quantity of cargo for changing over a receiving tank ashore, etc. Who are the first visitors to normally board a vessel once she has berthed, and what do they do? When well moored and the pilot and tugboats are off, the security checkpoint is established at the gangway and the vessel's port watch system enters into force. Depending on the country and port, the normal procedure will be that the quarantine and customs officers board the vessel first in order to clear the vessel and issue free pratique before any other persons are allowed to board the vessel. This means that the conditions on board do not pose a threat of medical infections and epidemics to the port, and that all goods on board are known and their transfer ashore is allowed under lawful control. Once cleared by the government authorities, who are the first two visitors who come on board for the ship's main business, and what is their function? When the vessel is cleared by quarantine and customs authorities, the loading master or terminal representative and cargo surveyors board the vessel. The loading master meets the chief officer, and together with him coordinates the functioning of the terminal's crew and systems with the ship. This includes connection of hoses, agreeing on the final discharge plan, safety, and other arrangements for the actual physical transfer of the cargo. The cargo surveyor is representing the receivers and cargo owners or charterers. His function is to make an accurate measurement of the quantity and quality of the cargo being transferred. What information do the cargo surveyors require in order to calculate the cargo arrival figures? As soon as the cargo surveyors have received a copy of the cargo documentation from the loading port, distribution of cargo grades in the tanks and the quantity, they then do their own tank survey, assisted by the pumpman and necessary deck crew. The tank survey includes taking samples of the cargo, cargo temperatures, ullages, and water dips. Why does connecting cargo hoses require close attention from the most experienced crew and deck officer from the ship, as well as the loading master and terminal staff? There are several risks in the connection of cargo hoses. Oil spill from the shore or ship's manifold when a blank flange is opened, the weight of a floating hose resting partly on the crane hook and not entirely by chains from the deck cleats, causing connection failure during the operation, the gasket either damaged or not sealing the manifold flange completely, injury to personnel in the considerable manhandling needed in positioning flexible hoses at an SPM. The loading master and his terminal staff or crew normally inspect the vessel's manifold and mooring arrangement before connection of hoses arms is initiated. From the vessel's side, the duty deck officer is now in charge of the activities on deck under the supervision of the chief officer. When berthed to an SPM for discharge through floating hoses, the hose connection operation is more demanding and requires experienced hands in addition to supervision of a loading master or his assistant. At some terminals, they have their own labourers for connecting hoses. There are several important factors to be considered with regard to connecting flexible cargo hoses, fixed arms or floating hoses for SPMs to the vessel's manifold. For further details, please refer to the International Safety Guide for Tankers and Terminals, ISCOT, OCIMF publication, Recommendations for Oil Tanker Manifolds and Associated Equipment. What are the three main subjects that must be discussed and agreed to in a ship shore meeting between the chief officer and the loading master? A ship and shore meeting is held in the chief officer's office or cargo control room or ship's conference room for pre-transfer exchange of information. The three main areas covered are the discharge plan, the safety, security and environment protection, and the communication and emergency stop procedures. Details of the ship's discharge plan, usually communicated before arrival, are discussed and, if in agreement with the terminal's receiving plans, are finalised. The items normally revised and added will be the time schedule, ballasting operation, ship and shore tank changeover, avoidance of contamination of cargo, pipeline clearing for discharge. Safety, security and environmental protection regulations of the ship as well as the terminal are an important matter to be discussed and agreed to. Finally, the communications channels and emergency stop controls are explained and tested. Click on the buttons below to view detailed checklists for various areas to be covered in the ship shore pre-transfer meeting. Information from tanker to terminal. Information from the terminal to the tanker. Agreed discharge plan, including permissions for crude oil washing. Ship shore safety checklist. Ship shore radio communications test and emergency stops. Click on the buttons to find out more. Before loading master disembarks, the ship or shore radio communication is established and procedures agreed upon. When the revised discharge plan and ship or shore safety checklist is ready, the junior officers, pumpman and bosun must be informed and the plan posted and made available for them to use throughout the discharge. The terminal's smoking regulations are to be posted, as well as the terminal's emergency alerting telephone numbers.